For today's video, we'll be taking a look at an AM5 motherboard from MSI that sports AMD's mid-range B850 chipset and is targeted at you folks out there who are intending to build a mid to high-end AMD AM5 PC in the micro ATX form factor, the MSI MAG B850M Mortar Wi-Fi. Sporting support for the latest Ryzen 9000 series of processors, as well as the Ryzen 8000 series of APUs, and the older Ryzen 7000 series of CPUs, we'll be taking a closer look at the specs of this board to see if it's any good. Let's get started. To recap, AMD launched its Zen 5 Ryzen 9000 series of processors back in August 2024, and the high-end X870E and X870 chipsets for the AM5 platform back in September 2024. January 2025 saw the arrival of AMD's mid-range and entry-level 800 series chipsets in the form of the B850 and the B840. With that, the MSI MAG B850M Mortar Wi-Fi, as its name implies, sports the B850 chipset and sits within the MAG series of mainstream motherboard offerings by MSI, where it places below MSI's performance-oriented MPG lineup as well as the range-topping flagship MEG series. As can be seen, the MAG B850M Mortar Wi-Fi comes in a grey box with green accents, and moving over to the rear, we get the usual overview of specs for this board. We'll run through these specs in detail later on in this video. On a side note, if you're new to the ALK Tech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest product releases in the PC hardware world. With that, let's have a look at the contents of the box. First up, we get a Wi-Fi antenna in this box right here, where the said antenna comes with MSI's new EZ antenna connectors that make hooking it up to the rear I/O of the board a breeze. Let's set aside the board for now to see what else MSI has included with it. First up, we get a single SATA 3 cable. And this is accompanied by an EZ front panel cable that helps make hooking up the front panel connectors of your PC case to the motherboard a breeze. In addition to this, we do also get a special 1-to-2 EZCon cable, a new MSI-specific feature that allows end users to connect MSI's new EZ series of ARGB fans to the motherboard with just one connector so as to simplify things. I'll cover EZCon in more detail later on in this video. We do also get two spare EZ M.2 Clip 2 attachments that facilitate the toolless installation and removal of your M.2 drives. And these are accompanied by an EZ M.2 Clip 2 remover tool, like so, as well as a spare M.2 drive screw. Now, in terms of documentation, we have here a quick installation guide, a regulatory information leaflet, like so, a MSI survey leaflet, as well as a sheet of MSI stickers. Onto the board itself, MSI's gone for a relatively clean aesthetic with a black colored PCB and large black heatsinks all around that feature lime green accents for a nice pop of color. Fans of RGB lighting effects might be disappointed to note that the board does not come with any onboard RGB LEDs, though it does of course come with an assortment of RGB headers, which I'll cover later on in this video. The board features an 8-layer PCB design and comes with an integrated I/O shield with decently sized VRM heatsinks. In terms of VRM specs, MSI has included 12+2+1 teamed power stages with 60 amp power phasors. The rear of the motherboard is quite a standard affair, though we do get some markings that serve as a warning not to install unneeded motherboard standoffs within your PC case, which could otherwise damage the board. MSI has also taken the liberty to include protective paint around the motherboard's screw holes so as to protect the PCB against scratches, which is a nice touch. For memory support, the MAG B850M Mortar Wi-Fi comes with 4 DDR5 slots, with a single tab design that, as of the time of publishing this video, comes with support for up to 256GB of RAM and the DDR5 8200 standard when overclocked. In terms of front panel USB connectivity, we get a USB 10Gbps Type-C front panel header right here. And moving over to the bottom edge of the board, a single USB 5Gbps Type-A front panel header where the set header provides for up to two USB 5Gbps Type-A ports. We do also get two USB 2.0 front panel headers nearby, with each header providing support for two USB 2.0 Type-A ports, for a total of four ports. Some interesting features to highlight: we get a tuning controller header that is to be used in conjunction with an optional tuning controller module that doesn't come included with the board. We also get an EZCon header right here. As mentioned earlier, EZCon is a new MSI-specific connector, and it allows end users to easily connect MSI's next-generation ARGB fans to the motherboard with just one onboard connector. For end users who do not have such MSI ARGB fans, the EZCon header can still be used with non-MSI devices via the included 1-to-2 EZCon cable included with the motherboard, which, as can be seen, comes with an addressable RGB header and a 4-pin fan header. We do also get an 8-pin supplemental PCIe power connector that provides for an additional source of juice for the power-hungry flagship GPUs of tomorrow. According to MSI, the said connector can provide up to 252 watts of supplemental power. Moving on, we get a safe boot jumper that, when enabled, forces the system to boot with default BIOS settings and lower PCIe link speeds from the CPU, a chassis intrusion header, as well as a clear CMOS header. Moving to this area right here above the primary PCIe 5.0 X16 slot, we see that MSI's also included a TPM header for an optional TPM module. And finally, near the RAM slots are a set of easy debug LEDs that can help with troubleshooting PC startup issues. In terms of expansion slots, this board comes with a PCIe 5.0 X16 slot for a graphics card. The said slot sports MSI's Steel Armor 2 design so as to reinforce the slot for use with heavy graphics cards. As can be seen, the slot also comes with the EZ PCIe Release feature that helps make removing a graphics card a painless affair. Pressing down on this button here will undo the latch for the installation or removal of a graphics card, and we even get a little window that shows whether the latch is locked in place or not. Pretty nifty. That's it, we do also get a PCIe 4.0 X4 slot right here. In case you're unaware, PCIe 5.0 is only supported when you have a Ryzen 9000 series or Ryzen 7000 series processor installed. It's worth noting that the Ryzen 8000 series of APUs only support the PCIe 4.0 standard. This means that if you do have a Ryzen 8000 APU installed on this board, depending on which model of APU that you have, the primary PCIe 5.0 X16 slot for a graphics card will operate at either PCIe 4.0 X8 mode or X4 mode instead. In the storage department, MSI has included 4 SATA 3 ports, with all ports in a right-angled configuration so as to aid with cable management. For M.2 slots, it comes with two PCIe 5.0 X4 M.2 slots, and over on the rear of the board, a PCIe 4.0 X2 M.2 slot, making this a rather unique AM5 micro ATX motherboard offering, seeing as it comes with more than two M.2 slots. Do note that all of these slots support NVMe SSDs only. M.2 SATA drives will not work in any of these slots. The primary M.2 heatsink features a toolless design called EZ M.2 Shield Frozer 2, which makes removing and installing the heatsink really easy. All you've got to do is press down on the button located at the side of the heatsink and lift the heatsink away from the board. Reinstalling it is a cinch too. Simply slide it back into place and press down until you hear a click. Another quality of life feature that the M.2 slots have is EZ M.2 Clip 2, which is a spring-loaded standoff device that makes installing and removing a M.2 drive a toolless affair, and installing it will require the use of the remover tool that comes included with the board. As can be seen, the EZ M.2 Clip 2 device is only to be used when you've got a shorter 2260 form factor drive to install on this board. Again, do bear in mind that PCIe 5.0 is only supported with a Ryzen 9000 series or Ryzen 7000 series processor installed. The Ryzen 8000 series of APUs only support the PCIe 4.0 standard. For audio, MSI has included a high-end Realtek ALC4080 audio codec, while for wired internet connectivity, we get a Realtek RTL8126VB chip that provides support for 5Gigabit Ethernet. Wi-Fi support is courtesy of a Qualcomm QCNCM865 Wi-Fi 7 part that supports the 320MHz channel width and also serves up Bluetooth 5.4 support. In the cooling and RGB departments, the board comes with 6 fan headers that are located in these regions of the board. Also included are 3 Gen 2 addressable RGB headers and a single 12V RGB header located in these regions. Moving over to the rear I/O, the MAG B850M Mortar Wi-Fi goes for an integrated I/O shield design. The board comes with a flash BIOS button that allows you to update the board's BIOS without needing to install a CPU, RAM or graphics card, a clear CMOS button, a HDMI 2.1 port that supports a maximum output resolution of 8K at 60Hz, 3 USB 10Gbps Type-A ports, a 5Gigabit Ethernet port, a USB 10Gbps Type-C port, 4 USB 5Gbps Type-A ports, a USB 20Gbps Type-C port, Wi-Fi antenna connectors with the new MSI EZ antenna connectors, as well as your usual audio jack connectors. To sum up, the MAG B850M Mortar Wi-Fi comes across as a pretty decent motherboard offering that's targeted at end users who are looking to build a higher-end AMD AM5 PC in the micro ATX form factor. The board sports a VRM setup that should handle high-end Ryzen 9000 series processors with ease, PCIe 5.0 support for both a graphics card and two M.2 drives, 5Gigabit Ethernet with built-in Wi-Fi 7, a nice array of USB Type-C and Type-A connectivity options, along with a whole bunch of quality of life features such as EZ PCIe Release, EZ M.2 Clip 2, and so on. Given the specs of this board, it definitely gives AM5 motherboards with the high-end X870E and X870 chipsets a serious run for their money, where with the B850 chipset and this board in particular, we don't get any PCIe lane bifurcation shenanigans that could otherwise end up affecting your PCIe 5.0 X16 slots bandwidth, as seen with some X870E and X870 motherboards that are currently available to purchase on the market. With that, thank you so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.